In this screencast, we are going to look at the monopsony labor market. A monopsony labor market is an imperfectly competitive labor market. We're going to explain what a monopsony market is. We're going to understand the relationship between the MRC, which is your marginal resource cost, and the supply curve. And we're also going to find the optimal number of workers to hire and the wage rate that they will get paid. You can see here that the monopsony graph does not look like the perfectly competitive graph. We don't have that perfectly elastic supply curve that is equal to the MRC. And that is because in the monopsony or imperfectly competitive labor market, they're known as wage makers instead of wage takers. And what that means is that the firms have more control over the wage rate and the amount that they are willing and able to pay the workers. And the reason for that is because there isn't as much competition for available jobs. For example, if you were somebody who was a hairdresser, and instead of having this ability to be able to work anywhere and to find jobs anywhere, you wanted to work around your town, then there's not going to be as many available jobs that are available. And also, they're now you're getting into more of a skilled type of job, and so we're not just dealing with this unskilled labor force. Another example I always think about is like with teachers, and if they want to work in a high school, they're limiting now the number of schools that they can work at. If they want to work where they're able to make it to work from their home in like maybe within a half hour's time, then they're also limiting the market that they're going to be able to apply for. And we have to be very skilled at what we do. And so those would be different things that would cause this to be a monopsony labor market. So when we're looking at this here, just recognize why we don't have this perfectly elastic supply curve that's equal to the MRC. And the term or the words that are known for that is that they are wage makers. Get into the imperfectly competitive. That's referred to as a monopsony. We have the same formulas here, but we've got definitely a different looking graph. We've got an upward sloping supply curve instead of it being perfectly elastic, because this is the amount that laborers are willing and able to supply their labor at a given quantity. The MRC or the MFC, the marginal factor cost, is greater than the supply curve because in order for firms to be able to hire another worker, they have to raise not only the wage rate for that new additional worker, but for all previous workers. And so the marginal resource cost is greater than the supply curve. We have our downward sloping demand curve. Demand equals MRP equals VMP. So in order to figure out the quantity, you go where MRP equals MRC, and that takes you down here, and that gives you the quantity or the laborers in this monopsony. The trick here is to figure out the wage rate. In order to figure out the wage rate, you go where MRC equals MRP, and you take it down to the supply curve, and that gives you the wage rate at this monopsony. Taking it down to the supply curve is something that a lot of students will get wrong, and so if you can remember that, then you will be very successful in being able to determine the quantity of resources hired in the monopsony and also the wage rate that they get paid. And this one here, we're going to